Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. In this video, we'll take a closer look at the report workspace. I'll show you how to create and edit report pages, use report templates, export your report, and how to use the integrated presentation mode to present and share your results. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. Let's get started. I'll open a project containing all the inspections from the tutorials, how to perform simple inspections, and how to perform GD&T inspections in ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. It contains nominal and actual data, inspection elements, and some report pages. If you want to know how the inspections were created, check out the two videos. Now, if you take a quick look at the project guide, you'll see that some inspections are not included in the report. Let's create two report pages for the GD&T inspections. One for the dimensions and one for the surface profile. When you first create the report page, you can edit the content, and choose a report style. Now, once you created report pages, you can find all of them in the Explorer and in the tab Report Pages. With the tab Report Page, you can view a single report page. But to work with report pages, I suggest you switch to the report workspace. In this workspace, the main toolbar contains the most important reporting functionalities. Beneath the main toolbar, you'll find the report templates. This tab contains all available report templates. You can click a template to see a preview. Underneath is the tab Report Pages. Now, just a reminder, this layout is entirely customizable, so feel free to move windows around or drag them off to view them on a second screen. What I'm describing here is the default layout. Now back to the tab Report Pages. Here you find all your report pages as a preview thumbnail. You can scale the size of the preview thumbnails by using Control and the mouse wheel. You can also change the order of the report pages with drag and drop. And you can rename the report page by clicking the name with the left mouse button. Like with report templates, you can display the report page by clicking it. At the bottom of your main workspace, you'll find the toolbar with various additional tools to edit report pages. On the right side, you can open and edit the properties of report elements. Okay, so much for a brief overview of the workspace. Now, let's use report templates to create and edit report pages. To create a new report page based on a template, simply drag and drop the report template into the tab Report Pages. Let's create a title page and a table of contents. You can also change the layout of an existing report page with a template by dragging the template onto the existing report page. If you want to edit a report page, simply click Edit Content. You can reposition the content and labels, zoom in and out, and so on. I'd like to change the image of the title page to the cat of the part. To do that, switch to the inspection workspace and display the cat exclusively in the 3D view. Back in the report workspace, select the title page and click Overwrite Report Page in the main toolbar. It allows you to overwrite the report page based on the current 3D view. To fine-tune the title page, click Edit Content and adjust the size and position of the part. Please note that Edit Content is only available with a Pro license. Now, let's talk about the main toolbar. With the first function, you can display the elements from the report page in the 3D view. To show you, let me minimize the tab Report Page so you can see the current 3D view. When you click Restore 3D View from Report page, the software automatically switches to the inspection workspace and displays the content of the report page in the 3D view. Alternatively, you can also drag and drop the report page from the Explorer into the 3D view in the inspection workspace. So you don't have to switch to the report workspace to do that. With Overwrite Report Page, you can change the content of the report page based on the current 3D view, like I just showed you with the title page. Reconfigure Report Page allows you to change the parameters of the report page without restoring or overwriting it. For example, you can update the alignment and legend to reflect the ones active in the current 3D view. This report page is based on a pre-alignment with a legend scaling of 1.5 millimeters. To update these parameters to the local best fit alignment and 1 millimeter legend, select from current 3D view for both the alignment and the legend. This is especially handy if you want to update multiple report pages. You can select them all and use Reconfigure Report Page. The next function is to find project keywords. Project keywords contain additional information about your project, and you can use them for the title page of your report. As you can see, once I enter project keywords, my title page is updated automatically. Next is the PDF export. The PDF can also contain videos. For more export options, please open File, Export, Report. That brings us to the last function, the screen presentation. It opens the interactive presentation mode. Not only does this mode allow you to present your report, which you could also do with a PDF, it allows you to basically have a simplified version of ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D at your disposal. First, let's activate full screen presentation. Now, with interactive 3D view, you can rotate the object, move it around, scale the view, drag labels, edit legends, and so on. All these changes are temporary. They do not have any impact on your actual report. With Restore 3D View from Report Page, you can jump back into the inspection workspace. To reset the view of your report page after changing it in presentation mode, click Reset View. To exit the full screen presentation, press Escape. To exit the presentation mode, click Exit Presentation Mode or use Escape again. The X on the right closes the entire project. Just so you know, the interactive presentation mode also supports touch devices, and you can share your project directly in presentation mode. This means that the recipient can work with the simplified user interface and view the results without having to know the software. To do that, check the box Open in Presentation Mode when you save the project. Now, of course, that's not everything ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D has to offer in terms of reporting. You can also customize the report master to include your company logo, for example, create your own custom templates, and much more. If you want to find out more, check out the INSPECT Optical 3D Basic eLearning. That's it for this short starter guide to ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. If you want to dive deeper into the world of ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D, take a look at our e-learnings and on-site trainings in the ZEISS Quality Training Center. Simply access it through the ZEISS Quality Suite or use the link provided in the description.